Gentleman yields. I now recognize Mr. Goldman of New York.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Our witnesses were asked whether what Secretary Mayorkas has done is intentional. Obviously, it's intentional. He's not doing things unintentionally. And he has testified before us, and he has acknowledged repeatedly that we are dealing with a very difficult situation at the border. I want to focus on, go back to what my colleague, Mr. Swalwell, was focusing on, which is my friend Mr. Bishop's quote that there is an intentional sabotage of the rule of law. Now, we've heard a couple times today that the GAO and a federal court found that Mr. Wolf was acting unlawfully. To my understanding, that would be a violation of the rule of law. But let's focus a little bit on some policies and some efforts. Mr. Jimenez mentioned that there are children who cannot be found, which brings up, of course, the Trump administration family separation policy. Mr. Wolf, when you were the chief of staff to the Secretary of Homeland Security, isn't it true that you supported the family separation policy?
I was at the department from 2017 to the end of the administration.
Well, did you not, according to an inspector general's report, urge the counselor to the attorney general to implement the family separation policy, to increase prosecution of family unit parents and separate family units?
No, I don't believe. No.
That's okay, well, I want to introduce into the record this inspector general's report on family separation, which includes an email by you to Gene Hamilton, the counselor to the attorney general.
So that email had a number of options.
Hold on.
For consideration, there was no direction, there was no direct.
So you're saying right here, right now, that you did not support the family separation policy.
That was not your question.
Is that your testimony?
That was not your question.
I'm asking it right now. Is that your testimony?
We implemented a number of policies in the administration. I agreed with President Trump when he ended zero tolerance in June, I believe, of 2018.
Did you
Absolutely.
Support the family separation policy?
Again, we had no family separation policy at the department.
Really? The department did not?
No, I'm happy to go through this.
All right,
The attorney general announced a zero tolerance policy that the department implemented.
Let's talk about this, because the facts are that more than 5,000 children were forcibly separated from their parents at the border. And the reason is because the Department of Justice, for the first time, used Title 8, United States Code, Section 1325, which makes it a misdemeanor offense to charge anyone crossing without without papers, et cetera. That had never been used before, because the only point of that is to put parents who are charged with that in jail where they cannot actually be with their families. Now, a federal court in 2018 ended the family separation policy, which this court determined that there was, because the government's policy, quote, shocks the conscience, unquote, and violates the constitutional right to family integrity. There are still children who were separated at the border from their parents who have not been found because this zero tolerance policy, which ultimately ended up separating parents and children, did not create any mechanism to account for that separation in order to track the children. Now, that clearly, as a judge said, was a violation of the rule of law. An intentional sabotage of the rule of law. Let me go quickly to another one. According to a whistleblower complaint by the former head of the department's intelligence branch, Mr. Wolf ordered him to withhold an intelligence notification on Russian activities because it, quote, made the president look bad. The Office of Inspector General investigated it and found that the department did not adequately follow its internal processes and policy standards
when editing and disseminating an intelligence product regarding Russian interference with the 2020 presidential election. And the acting secretary, Mr. Wolf, participated in that review process. Mr. Chairman, I know my time is up. I'd like to introduce for the record that Inspector General's report, which my staff will give. And I would like to note that before we start attacking this intentional sabotage of the rule of law, we ought to look in our own glass house. And I yield.
Without objection, so ordered.